Hi, I'm Erica Gamet with InDesign Secrets, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the based on feature when using text styles in InDesign. Basing a style on another or creating a style hierarchy lets you update and change many styles all at once, and it also makes sure that your document styles are kept consistent and in sync with each other. So in this document, I have my first style all set up, and that's my body text. I generally take the style that I think will be most prevalent in my document and use that as sort of my base or my starting point. Most of my other styles are going to be based on this style, and then that way if I decide to, say, change the font in this body text, all my other styles that are based on that will also change to the new font. So I already have the body text style defined, and now I'm ready to make a header style. So usually what I do is create a new text frame, and I'll type in some text. This is the header. And I'm going to select that text or just put my cursor inside the paragraph because it is paragraph style. And I'm going to assign the body text style to it. Now I want to make any changes that are going to be specific to the header style. So I'm going to select this text and I'm going to make it bigger. Let's make it 36 point. I'm going to make it bold. I can use the pull down menu if I want. I used my keyboard shortcuts. And I also want to make it all caps. So I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut for that as well. Shift Command or Shift Control K to make that all caps. Now when I made those changes down in the body text, I can see that there's a little plus and that shows me that there are overrides. So I've made changes. I put bold, 36, and all caps. So what I want to do now is create my header style based on the changes I just made. To do that, I'm going to Option or Alt click on the Create New Style button and it opens up the new paragraph style dialog box, and I'm just going to go ahead and call this header. I don't really need to do anything else because the work's already been done for me. I can see that it's already based on body text. That's because I assigned body text before I created the new style. And then it also added those overrides in. So it's body text plus bold plus 36 point plus all caps. The thing to keep in mind here is that everything that's in body text will update. If I change body text, it will update in this particular header style, with the exception of any overrides I made. So it will remain bold, 36 points, and all caps, but everything else, that underlying style, when that gets changed, this style will also update. So all I need to do at this point is just tell it OK. Oh, and make sure that Apply to Style to Selection is on. That means everything I've already got selected, that style will be applied to. I say OK. And now my header style is applied to that style that's there. I'm going to do one more. I'm going to create another one and say, this is the subtitle. Select it all. Click body text again. Option or Alt click on the create new style. We'll call this subhead. Based on body text. And here I can create some changes as well. If I didn't do it earlier, I can make the changes right here inside the dialog box. So I can come in here. Let's go ahead and change this to italic. And we'll make it just slightly bigger, maybe 22 point. I want to make sure that Apply Style to Selection is on, and I can see that it's body text plus italic plus 22. We'll say OK to that. Now I have those styles set up. Now if I were to go ahead and make changes to the body text style, let's just come in here and we change the font, let's say, to, let's do Palatino. Come on, Palatino, there we go. Now everything changed because the base style changed to Palatino, and I didn't override the font in any of my other styles. So when I make a change here, it updates through all my styles. Let's say OK to that. Now this also works in character styles, though I use this a little less frequently for those. And that's mostly because my character styles are fairly simple and streamlined. I find that tying them to other styles adds a layer of complexity to them, and that just generally doesn't work for my workflow, but it might for yours. Either way though, basing one paragraph style on another paragraph style is an easy way to update and maintain consistent styles throughout your document. Well, I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and to subscribe to our monthly publication, InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.